Draft your LCS team and earn money. Alpha Draft.
First team of the EU LCS expansion torn to head into the LCS itself.
Yeah, indeed. And you have to think H2K right now are making a strong case for themselves being that number 9 team in LCS. But it's not over yet for Giants. The problem Giants have got, though, is after selecting red side 5 games and now it didn't pay off in game 1, they've got to go back to the drawing board. They have to look perhaps to ban away the Jarvan and look at better matchups for themselves just in general.
So they're going to have to make some serious changes to their champion select. Yeah. And going from the red side, they'll have to do something very interesting. As we can see, we are heading into that champion select very shortly here. And Syndra, Jace, and Xerath will be the first banned champions, all aimed at that mid lane. Jace and Zed as well banned out, so it's just mid lane all over the place.
Yeah, no Jarvan ban yet out of Giants, and what is that going to leave available? Lee Sin has not been banned away from Lulex yet either, so Giants are in a situation where they're letting one of H2K's top jungle picks through here, and that is a big factor as we go through picks and bans. LeBlanc is going to be the last one out of H2K, so all three bans focus to Pepinero. His Twisted Fate is potentially available, and they're going to say we'll leave both available. You get one, we'll get the other.
Right, so Rumble will be the final ban coming out here. LeBlanc, as you mentioned, was the final ban coming in from H2K. Yep. But Rumble will break the trends of all of the mid laners just being banned here. That will be thrown up at the top lane.
Yep.
So what do H2K bring out here? The Jarvan is still available. We saw how well that did in the last game and how much of a focal point that was for them.
So here's the difficult thing for H2K now. They can pick Lulex, his top champion of Lee Sin, and then give the Jarvan, which is Frederick's most comfortable champion. Or they can do the inverse, go with the Jarvan again. They know it worked for them last time. They don't want to give it to Giants. What's the decision they're going to make here? Is it even going to be a jungle pick? Will we see something like a Janna? We saw how much Giants struggle to engage. Will we see a disengaged champion here out of H2K?
Yeah, it's very possible coming in here. You know what else is open? TF is open. And if they leave the Jarvan out here, I wouldn't be surprised if we see Giants just lock in their golden combination of TF Jarvan.
Okay, so this is H2K basically saying, we actually don't really mind which one you take, so we're going to prioritize the lane that we feel is going to do so much better for us. And you can see insta-locks on jungle and support.
Yeah, Frederick likes his Jarvan. It's one of his biggest champions, and it allows him to do pretty much anything. Pepinero, we'll see what he brings into the mid lane now, but as long as they have the Jarvan, that's the core of that combo. Yeah. Down. Now they have the Fresh coming out as well, coming in again for Rydal. We said about this last game, giving this one of his highest priority champions down there. Now we're just waiting for H2K to see what they'll bring to the mix.
Yeah, I wonder whether they're going to opt for a very safe mid laner, something like an Orianna or you know, something to the effect of the Ahri that we've seen Forbidden play time and time again. He's very comfortable on Ahri, has been confident to pick it into matchups, and we already know he doesn't really think Pepinero is as strong as everybody's making him out to be, but it doesn't look to be the case. There is the Janna that we were expecting out of H2K. It caused a lot of problems from Giants, but this time they have better engage. They've got a Jarvan. Using that Cataclysm is going to be able to get on top of H2K. Still have to play around Monsoon, though.
Yeah, Monsoon and the Valkyrie as well is deciding to try and jump on top of Hyannon. But here comes the Janna. Here comes a Lee Sin as well for the jungle. That will be going on to Lulex most likely here, and that will be the next two pickups from H2K.
Yeah, so where do Giants go from here? Do they go for the Sivir pick, which, while it worked out actually quite well in the bottom lane, you could hear that Sane and Krepa were talking about how many dive opportunities they had. It does struggle in that later game phase, and there's still a top laner still to be picked for H2K. So you kind of put yourself in an awkward situation. Giants could just opt for the same again. The Jinx is still available. We've seen them play Jinx into Corki. We've seen them play it with Thresh as well. And with Jarvan, it makes for a lot of you know, catch engage potential when you can get excited, keep going, and get everybody locked inside that Cataclysm. We'll see what their choice is. It is going to be the Sivir.
Yeah, they've decided on the Sivir here again, coming in from Adri. And for the mid lane, it will be Pepinero picking up the Ahri once again. In fact, no, he didn't pick that last game, but he will be picking the Ahri in here for the mid lane. And that will be going up against Forevervin in the mid lane, but he hasn't chosen his champion either. But we'll be seeing now.
And it's really interesting that Pepinero doesn't want the counter for mid and that they're giving it over to Whirlybee. So the decision here from Giants to make sure that they counter pick their top laner, we'll see how it works. They played Jax a couple of times. We'll see whether they go for that again. Depends on what H2K want to pick for that top lane. Lissandra is available. And looking at other champions that are available, Maokai, should they want to pick it, is another pick that H2K have played a good few times.
So they do lock in the mid laner here. Orianna comes out from Forbiven, coming in for the mid lane. Just waiting on the final pick now, which should be at that top lane for H2K.
Ah, that's and also available.
Yeah, that's also available. We completely skimmed over that one, but the iReady, a high priority pick, not only in EU LCS expansion tournament, but also for these players, and an insta-lock of that Jax as well for Whirly B. Again, he was playing this yesterday. I feel like we're back in Season 2.
Well, I also feel like we're back in the other games from 2 days ago, as this Jax worked out very well for Giants. And if you want scaling, Odo Amne says, I'll go quite late. I'll pick a Jax. He's going to go even later into game. The only real difference in this Giants composition to what they were running the other day is they're running Sivir instead of Jinx. So Giants are uncomfortable champions. And that's an interesting prospect here as we head into this game.
It is indeed. So we have all of these lineups now solidified here. So we do have that Ahri, as you mentioned as well. The Sivir has come out for the On the Hunt, that big ultimate that will be going down in the bot lane with Rydal. So what does that mean for the entire composition here as we look down the roster from Giants?
Well, the Giants lineup is going to be able to catch quite easily. Use that Sivir ult, allows Jarvan to get in position. You've got the hook, you've got the charm as well from Ahri. So this is a lot stronger with regards to how Giants like to play for this game.
It is indeed. So we are only moments away from getting into this game. We'll see who comes out ahead in this one. H2K, of course, are one game up in this series in this best of five coming into this one strong. Pepinero, we'll see if he can do something about that, shut them down in this game. Frederick, of course, has his Jarvan in this game, and that'll probably help them out.
We'll see. We'll see if it helps them out, because H2K picked it as their top champion in the last game. No, it is Giants that have it. And speaking of Giants, they are once again on the red side with Whirly B in the top lane, Frederick in the jungle this time, and Pepinero in the mid lane, Adri and Rydal down in the bottom lane.
Apparently they've still swapped up with the enemy team, but that doesn't matter. Odawandi in the top lane, Lulix in the jungle, Febavin in the mid lane, Hyalan and Voidal will be that duo lane for the bot lane.
So we're on to the Rift. And we'll see whether the Deep Wards come out again. We're saying that every single time, because some teams are opting to do it. Others are playing more defensively. And Faculty and Reason were certainly playing a lot more defensive when it came to their level one starts. So in this matchup, very similar to the last game. In fact, identical bot lane, actually, for Giants going for that Sivir Thresh. It worked out for them. We'll see if it works out for them again.
Oh, in the top lane, we'll be bumping heads here. But again, guys, make sure to head us up on social media at LOL Sports using the hashtag LCS Expansion to get your thoughts over to us. Tell us how you think this series is going to go, because this will be deciding the LCS team, at least the ninth team coming into the LCS here for the spring split in EU. As the ward goes over the wall, we'll be putting up that vision, allowing them that early game information onto Frederick Starr, and indeed the bot lane from Adrian Rydal, if they'll decide to go for that.
Yeah, last game we saw Adrian Rydal invade on the Krugs over on blue side. This time the ward has gone down in favor of H2K, so they're going to be able to spot out where the Giants are trying to start on Gromp, but you can see they certainly are not this game. Bit of a different start out of them. Are they going to look to go aggressive into the bottom lane? That is the question. Looks like they just want to set up the minion wave for themselves.
So, again, it will be Jax now here. Whirly B, he was doing this yesterday. He's going to be doing it again, starting off in one of these camps. But now Rydal and Adri come around the corner.
This
be seen
real.
Out by Hyonan and Voidal. Phosphorus Bomb comes out. Rydal lands the Flay onto two, getting that charge as well from the auto attack. Boomerang Blade will even up the odds, but Rydal gets the short end of the trade.
H2K just reading what Giants were looking to go for. That was really nice out of H2K, knowing they could get the better trade here to start this lane off. And Whirly B, once again, going to get that level two on Jax and head up to the top lane, see how Odo Amne deals with it.
So he didn't actually decide to teleport back to base and teleport into the top lane. He just chugged through a couple of those health potions, but he's also started with the Chalice.
Yeah, so both of them starting Flask are going to know that this is kind of just going to be farm for a while. You can see Lulex dropping very low on his first buff as well. But with the Flask, both just going to sustain up here. So Whirly B knows he's got quite a lot of time here to just get back up to full health in lane.
Yeah, Lulex again up against the Murkwolves. Hopefully be in a better position than he was last game as Jarvan, as he sustains through the jungle. Bottom lane here, Voido on the Janna, Hyonan on Corki. We're going up against the counterparts of Adri, now on the Sivir. Rylo again on Thresh.
Yeah, this time is a lot better in favor of H2K. They've got into this lane and they have a very slight lead right now with regards to CS. But we'll see whether Frederick opts to change his jungle paths this time, because Lulex in the last game really just read Frederick every single time he went for a gank, every time he wanted to get into a lane. Lulex is just there, and he will get that Razor Sharp. No, he didn't choose to smite it in the end, so he's going to hold that for his buff, of course. So won't be able to take away any wards from Giants this early on.
Yeah, he's gone for those Raptors. We'll be moving on to the red buff as well.
Makes
now
a lot of
here.
Sense. We saw him do this last game.
Yeah, here comes the smite, and should be able to take the Bramble back down, get that buff, clear out those minions as well, which have all those extra experience on them now, so important to clear them out. Also in your own jungle, because you want it to be respawning on time, so you can pick that up in 5 minutes' time. But mid lane, once again, it will be ex-Pepinero on his Ahri, but Febervent now onto Orianna. Slight CS advantage onto Orianna at this point in the game, but both level 3. In fact, no, Febervent is level 4. Looks at, is now level 4 himself, and take a look at Frederick in the top lane.
Yeah, he's looking for an early gank into a different lane here, and he's going to sit around. Will he choose to go in? There is no vision from Odo Amne on this. Ooh, there we go.
Now is not the right time to be warding, and he has to burn his flash for it.
It's a flash that Frederick will take right now. We'll see whether they can come back into that lane and make it count, as a kill on Odo Amne would certainly set Whirly B up very nicely for this game.
That would be nice, but they will just carry on farming. Pretty even so far in that top lane. Again, in the mid lane, these two big playmakers, lots of chatter over the mid laners of the EU Challenger scene, have really been the big talking points for a lot of people. Both junglers heading into the top lane once again.
Yeah, I wonder, Lulex, I think, has a decent read here, thinking Frederick is probably going to come back around after that first gank. He is going to get spotted out by a ward.
Well, flag drag, and the auto attack onto Lulex will be turning around with the Sonic Wave. Whirly B now comes in here, gets the stun from Counter-Strike onto Lulex, but not before he safeguards to his ally of Odo Amne. Pepinero heading into the top lane, trying to find that charm, but ward jump over the wall from Lee Sin gets him away from trouble.
Yeah, it's been read out by the wards from H2K as well. Frederick showed on that top lane ward just before it died as well. And that is making it tough for Giants to change up their strategy. They really need to get either Pepinero or Whirly B going. The other option is if Adri can get going in this bottom lane. Once again, it started to go in their favor. And Rydal, if he can land the hooks like he did last time, could really set up this bottom lane to be a big carrying factor for Giants.
Rydal always finds the right moment to just land the CC, consistently landing in the bottom lane. Lulex moving into the top lane here up against Whirly B, fairly low on his health. We'll be looking to back off here. He sees that from the minion line, and Lulex will go back to base as well.
Yeah, Whirly B knows with that many minions pushing out, he's in a very precarious position without backing away. So he heads back, picks up the Sheen for himself, and is going to get back into lane. Irelia looked actually to opt for the Phage, then sold it, picks up the Sheen after all. So both of them going for that little bits of spikes of damage in the trades.
So Pepinero did decide to go into the bot lane, has not been seen out, but the charm over the wall, Hyana is getting blown up, but is it enough damage? The Spirit Rush comes away here, and will he be meeting his mid lane? In fact, Febervent did not go all the way to the bot lane, and Voidal sticks around. Hyana is actually choosing to stay around as well. This is risky.
It is quite risky, but without Rydal landing something like a flash hook onto Corki, it won't exactly be the end of the world. He does still have heal available, and with Frederick in the mid lane, they know it's not going to be another dive in the bottom lane either. So Giants have opened up an opportunity for themselves, though. They could look to get Frederick down in that bottom lane in the next couple of minutes and punish Corki for not having his flash available.
So with the first backs in this game, we can see people have gone back to base, picked up their first bunch of items. Looks like the Mirella Nomicon will be one of the first items from Pepinero in the mid lane, with the Forbidden Idol and Phoenix Codex. On the flip side, we will be seeing that Chalice in the mid lane for Forbidden. And top lane, both have opted towards the Sheen components of the Trinity forces.
And speaking of top lane, Lulex,
he will be aggressing onto him, only level 5 though, so won't be able to kick him back into his ally. Whirly B smacks him in the face with the empowered auto attack and relentless assault. Frederick in the jungle now, level 5, but soon to be level 6 himself, getting that Cataclysm. Will be just picking up those early buffs.
He also chose not to clear out the ward, wanted the Q instead. Okay. Wanted to go aggressive onto Whirly B and try and punish him for coming down, but no real comeuppance from that, but they'll know that there's a bit of vision up in that top side still for Giants. First blue buff goes over to Forbiven, who is in a very comfortable position. He's a little bit of CS up on Ahri as well. Pepinero is going to have to try and Roma now when his ultimate is available again. He needs to get an advantage somewhere else on the map, because it's very difficult to kill Forbiven on Orianna. Very difficult to actually get him that low in lane.
So we're 8 minutes into this game, Stress, and this is like one of the latest first bloods we've ever seen.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't say ever. In the expansion tournament, this is one of the latest first bloods we've had. We did have a couple of passive games as well, but certainly Giants have kind of swapped up their style. They're a little more hesitant to head mid so often now that H2K have been reading. This game's been a lot more about the top lane, as junglers have been up there quite a few times. Willy B now does have his ultimate available under this tower, so H2K probably don't really want to dive him, because that'll be difficult to kill the Jax, especially if he can get that Counter-Strike off.
Yeah, indeed. So, Pepinero takes away his own blue buff. Both of those junglers now have picked up their first jungle items. Lulux takes the Trailblazer here, in fact, over the Stalker's Blade. Stalker's Blade has been picked up by Frederick, so seeing a little bit of a difference here from the jungler of Lee Sin. Typically, you do see the Stalker's Blade, but Rydell finds himself another hook in the bottom lane. Box comes down, and Valkyrie comes away to a support of Voidal.
Yeah, good hook again out of Rydell, though. Did expend the box. So that's a big cooldown for that bottom lane. Janna has just hit level 6, so Monsoon is now available. So with Frederick down in this bottom lane, they should be able to disengage this, but it's all about the engage. Frederick is rearing up for this gank. Here he goes.
The flag and drag onto two players. Vlade comes backwards. Janin is not able to get away. Doesn't have the flat. Does have the Valkyrie. Voidal smacks them against the wall with a Monsoon, but Frederick comes in range with Cataclysm, dunks him for the kill.
Yeah, Frederick just got the knockup on the way in, so no need to use Cataclysm early on. That's what Voidal was saving the Monsoon for, but it's not enough if you don't engage with Cataclysm to begin with. That's a great pickup here for Giants to begin this game. It is going to be the first Dragon of the game going to them as well, and really nice work down in that bottom lane. That's what our analysts said that Giants had to do.
Yeah, this is a series of firsts, because again, another earlier Dragon from what we've been seeing, a 10-minute Dragon going down, and the first blood finally coming out at the 10-minute mark as well for Giants. So they will be leading this game, as opposed to last game where H2K were getting ahead in these skirmish fights. Giants, of course, last game were still ahead in their lanes. You could see that in the gold totals before, and that has resulted in their items as well. But you can see up and down the board, yes, the bottom lane is ahead with Adri, but top lane is behind and mid lane is behind as well from H2K.
And Orianna is sitting on a lot of gold in that mid lane. You saw it up on your screen there, about 1,700 gold still to go back and buy, and that's the same for a couple of players in this game. Everybody's kind of just playing out passive and haven't reached the point where they want to back away to pick up more items. Lulex is again going up to this top lane. He spent a good few minutes here top lane not actually going in for any ganks, and he hasn't been able to get any kind of focus, and especially with the Ranger's Trailblazer, which is far more of a farming item, he's not exactly that far ahead in the jungle farm either. So very interesting decision out of Lulex to wait around here. He's gonna go in.
Here comes Lulex. He will be using the kick, knocks him into his ally. He goes down, but Lulex is very low himself. Frederick does not have the Cataclysm from the gank in bot lane. He drops low as well. Odiwane flashes forward, Equilibrium Strike in with the double kill.
Doesn't matter how much time you spend there, as long as you make it count. That is a big play there out of H2K. 2-0 now on Irelia. He's gonna give her an easier time against this very high scaling Whirly be on Jackson. That lane is already going significantly in favor of Odoamne, and that is making it even more tough now for Whirly B. He is going to have to try and find some time to farm, and I don't think he's going to find it.
Well, Pepinero playing with fire, especially as the Shockwave comes through. He will have to use his ultimate as well. Spirit Rush is burnt, so both of those big ultimates are used. Pepinero will actually just leash the Merc Walls for Frederick, who is coming into the mid lane. But he is looking for the gank himself. He does have that Cataclysm available, plus the Flash if he needs it. Still staying around the mid lane. Febavin level 9 to level 7. And Frederick realizes he can't do anything and waddles out of lane.
So Forbiven using Shockwave there, what that's going to do is, as it forced the ultimate out from Pepinero, it means Pepinero can't roam quite so much, and Forbiven is going to just farm, and then if Ahri tries to leave the lane, just push into the turret and try and just get as much map control as possible. It's a fairly short cooldown on Shockwave, so it's not actually that big a deal. It just means for the next minute or so, Pepinero's impact is far lower, potentially, than it could be.
So Forbiven in the mid lane once again, just sticking to his lane. And Lulex, he spent a lot of time in the top lane. It was the third time he went into the top lane that finally paid off. Two kills to his top lane of Odawamne. Has that Trinity Force now.
He's
at 13 minutes.
Going aggressive into the jungle, though.
Not too bad, but the junglers are going to meet each other here. Lulex finds the other jungler and right into his mid laner. Cataclysm comes down, locks Lulex, but it's a minor inconvenience because he goes down. Pepinero comes in, though, flashes right in with the Foxfires. Rydal comes in from the bottom lane, but Febavin is still looking to deal the damage. But now with Janna coming in from the bot lane as well, Rydal comes across and lands the hook. He will actually go in on this. The Flay comes down. Adria is here from the bottom lane. The Charm doesn't land, but a teleport from the top lane. Fevin's coming in. Odawamne is full health, has the Transcendent Blaze, but is not in range for his Blade Surge. Now he Blade Surges onto Whirly B, gets the stun down from the Counter-Strike. Hyonin now joins the party from the bottom lane. Everyone is in the mid lane, but no one dies.
A long, extended team fight there, and you could see that Pepinero couldn't get anywhere close to Frederick before he ended up falling in that engage, and it's all due to that ultimate timer being down from there. Everybody kind of teleporting in. You can see Whirly B item-wise is so far behind Odawamne right now. A completed Trinity Force to just a Sheen and the makings of a Phage makes it very difficult for Whirly B to stay anywhere near Odawamne this early on in the game. And H2K went aggressive into the jungle. They find Frederick and get the kill. That's another big play out of H2K. They are making sure that they can punish Frederick at every turn.
Yeah, Frederick, despite being that usual big playmaker for his team, is always being shut down by Lulex. He's always one step ahead of him and one page forward in the storyline. Odawamne in the top lane takes away this minion wave, and he is now significantly ahead of Jax. 125 farm to 77.
So far ahead right now, and that is really pushing Whirly B further and further back into this game. You can see it's now well over 1,500 gold between the two, and that's not a good spot for Jax. And you know what? I was talking to Broken Shard, the coach of H2K, and I think they were probably anticipating a Jax pick here because everybody was talking in the player lounge the other day about, I was asking, why is Jax such a first pick for Giants? Why are they doing it? And everyone was saying, we don't really know because you can just punish Jax. Yeah. Like, he's very easy to push back into the lane as long as you give him some attention. If you let him farm, he will get into the late game and just kill you. But it feels like H2K prepared for this scenario of Whirly B playing Jax, and you can see it's working out for them. They've put Frederick and Jax really far behind.
And this will hurt them a lot as we move into the mid game. A useless Jax will not be helping them out at all. Odawamne and Febivin in the mid lane will be pushing down this turret. Efenero comes in. That's a fast Frederick, though, with the on hunt buff from Sivir in the bot lane. But Dreidel gets kicked into his team. They take him down as they are rotating into the middle lane. And H2K will be quite happy taking that one away.
Lulex with the flashy plays dodges out of the hook, kicks back in, and really just no way that Rydal was going to be able to get anything from that. And as good as Rydal's Thresh has been, you have to feel that H2K just all around the board have been just stronger so far in these two games than Giants have been able to cope with.
Now, just another example of high-level Lee Sin plays in this game.
And at this point, H2K, they take the tower. They're heading over to Dragon as well. This is going to be very difficult for Giants to kind of come back without Jax getting significant amounts of farm. You can see just how much damage.
That's a big chunk of damage from Forbidden, but he's also getting chunked down from Pepinero. In comes the dunk from Frederick. He picks up the kill, but Lulex is ready to meet him with the kick to the face. Takes him down. A one-for-one trade so far. Voidal was now under attack. He'll flash away. Adria is still trying to chase after, but now he's a little bit out of position because Odawamne is trying to get onto his face. Whirly B now on Lulex and Hyonin going one on three. He picks up one. Can't go any further. Odawamne, though, is going to town on Giant. He takes down everyone on the back lines. A 3-for-2 in favor of H2K.
Whirly B landed a really nice counter strike in the middle of that, but it wasn't quite enough to deter H2K. He just doesn't have the damage to really follow it up with multiple kills. He gets one, which is nice for him. But in this situation, Giants just threw everything they had at H2K, and H2K just stood there and took it, and now they're going to take a Dragon as well. They've increased Irelia's lead now to 4-0-1, as Odawamne did hot-foot it down from the top lane. And right now, H2K are again looking in a great position here in Game 2.
Yeah, that is a scary-looking Irelia. She'll be going back to base with a fair chunk of change in her back pocket. In fact, she's already gone back to base and has picked up that Giant's belt.
Yeah, opting to just be a little bit tankier rather than the Zephyr build that we've seen other players like Wicked pick up. And I think that's just going to make Irelia just so much more difficult to deal with right now. She's got enough damage as it is. You can see just how much she's shredding through people in these fights that for her, there's really really no reason to get anything but tank. But take a look over at Sivir's items as well. Bits and pieces of an Infinity Edge, of a Static Shiv there as well. Adri just doesn't have too much damage right now, and Giants just need damage coming from somewhere.
Frederick, also, you can see, case in point really there, is Odoane with the damage onto that jungler. He does have that Warrior Enchant now and has opted towards the Spirit Stone, so he's not the most tanky Jarvan in the world. He does have the Cataclysm and the Flash as well, so the utility is absolutely something he'll bring to the table, as well as a big chunk of damage. Adri almost caught out by Lulex as he will move through the jungle with Voidal, putting down all the pressure in terms of those wards. 2,000 gold ahead, but in terms of map pressure and map control, H2K are flying through.
And H2K just item-wise as well, even if they weren't so far ahead, it's very difficult to deal with a double Trinity Force team when they've reached this kind of spike, unless you're ahead against them. And the fact that H2K have a gold lead as well, and they've got the dragons, makes it real tough for Giants. They're going to have to wait out and get some big items here. They need 2-3 items on people before they can really start to contest. However, this is one thing they can do. Odoamne's not going to let Whirly Bee do it, though.
No, and he's going to go up against him using the Counter-Strike, tries to get out of range of that stun, but he's ready and waiting with another Blade Surge, Transcendent Blades
oh,
as
look
well.
Who's here.
But we do have Lulex from the backside. Does he even need to use his ultimate? No, he does not. Flying kick to the face as he runs away. Whirly Bee goes down.
Yeah, Whirly Bee wanted to split push, and that is what you do on Jax, but he didn't even have a Trinity Force before he died then, has now picked it up. It just means you can't really be that far out. You don't have the vision. There was no wards on the side of Giants anywhere near the river or topside jungle out of H2K. That's just a very kind of desperate, over-aggressive split push out of Whirly Bee, and Frederick has been caught.
Hello, I'm Lulex, and I have a kick, but Fresh has a lantern, takes him back to safety, but Pepinero will not be so lucky. He'll have to use a Spirit Rush to get away, but uses the last charge to go back in. So much damage onto Voidal. Now the teleport comes in from Jax. He'll be cleaning up Lulex as he comes in. A nice 1-0, and Jarvan didn't even go down. So that comes out ahead for Giants. The first hook misses now from Rydal, but he does get the box down onto Hyonan. Whirly Bee jumps in with an empowered leap strike, but Odoamne gets the reset on the minion, jumps right onto the carrier Pepinero. Frederick now still has his ultimate, comes in with the ultimate as well. A 3-2 in favor of Giants, but he goes down for the pleasure. Now Forbidden and Hyonan are pushing down the middle lane, up against the support and bottom lane of Giants.
It's two damage dealers out of HGK, but all the way back in that fight, the Thresh Express just saving Frederick, and Lulex went deep. He went far too deep onto two players out of Giants, and they will clean him up. And getting kills onto Whirly Bee is a good thing here for Giants. He is their one saving grace, that if they can draw this game out, they can really start to get Whirly Bee split pushing in this game. The difficulty they have is I don't know whether H2K will make a mistake like that again. They are normally very confident, very composed, and that was perhaps a little bit of over-aggression out of H2K.
It was over-aggression, but it didn't result in a huge lead for Giants.
Exactly.
They're still ahead in this game here, Stress. 3,000 gold ahead, and the two towers over Giants as well. So, as you mentioned, it was a small blunder, but they probably won't be making it again. But we have to make sure that they don't play too passive. However, I'm not too concerned with these two teams. They're some of the most aggressive teams we have here in the LCS expansion tournament.
They are. They certainly are more aggressive than Reason and Faculty. But, you know, giving that many kills over to Jax, that has kind of got him back into this game a little bit. You can see he's had time to farm. He's now at 140 CS to the 152. 3 kills to his name. Trinity Force and most of Aranduin's completed as well. So that actually is a big factor for Whirly Bee. He can now actually confidently split push. I wonder whether he can actually duel Odoamne. That is a bigger question. Is sure, he's confident enough to go out there. Can he do enough with it, though?
Oh, Pepinero does have that Q on himself. The shockwave only hits Rydal, though, but Frederick has used his ultimate. Oh, there's the follow-through. The flying Jarvan right into the face of Pepinero. He goes down. Lulex is still chasing after. Connects the Q, connects the damage. Adri drops low, jumps over the wall, but the last auto-attack from Hyalan will follow him. 4-0 so far, and Whirly Bee comes into the fight too late, and this whole team is dead.
Giants just played into H2K's hands there, and H2K are going to really look to push from this one. Another really good play out of Lulex. I don't know why you'd let him get Lee Sin, if I'm being honest. Frederick wanted Jarvan from champion select, and giving Lulex his best champion, you can see exactly how much effect he's had on this game. 5-3-5, it's very difficult to deal with him now.
And Whirly Bee will be just having to clear out the minions waves here. H2K fairly healthy. We'll be taking away the inhibitor turret now, 5-1, taking away the bottom turret as well. Kianen was able to take that one away. That was a large minion wave set up for them just a couple minutes ago, ready to move into position. They are taking every single objective by the book. Oh, the Dragon Strike interrupts Lulex. He actually stays still. He wasn't expecting a Jarvan from nowhere. Flang and Drag once again. He has to use the flash. We'll be kicking him away. Kianen comes into the rescue. So that's a big summoner and his kick burn.
Yeah, they know there's no smite available on Jarvan now, and with 4 seconds until Dragon comes up, H2K could look to just force Giants away because it's risky for them to do Dragon with no smite. Yes, yes, Lee Sin is so far away here, but now you risk somebody coming in and bursting it down, and against Corki, it could be tricky. Will H2K go?
Oh, he gets it! Oh, he got it with the missile! How did that even happen? Kianen!
Well, that's the risk. That's the risk with Stalker's Blade right there. You use Smite as a giant objective is coming up, and a rocket just out of the side, perfectly timed by Kianen, making that first pick Corki work.
Unbelievable. Picks up the dragon coming in. Now two dragons on them, and Giants literally got nothing from that. They didn't even kill the Lee Sin. Yes, they got his flash, but that is a small consolation prize for losing the dragon.
It is. Odo Amne's fan Pepinero as well.
He's coming in, connects the blade. So that's a Frederick over the wall. Lulex now coming in. Just land the ultimate onto two. Lulex is being dragged into the team. Death Sentence goes down and lives up to its name. Or will it? Yes, he goes down. But the Shockwave also came into the backside. Wordy B from the top trying to get into Febiven in the mid lane. The jungler goes down, but the top turret went down as well for H2K.
And at the same time, Super Minions are pushing into the base. And that means Giants have to do something to deal with them. And the rest of H2K are just looking to push all of the waves. Wave management has been quite a key point that Deficio has been making all week here, and H2K are just trying to set that up for themselves, but you can see that Forbidden has a long way down to that bottom lane. He's looking for blue buff at the moment, but he's not going to be able to find it there.
No, he will not, but Giants in this game, they are firmly behind now. 9,000 gold behind, 6 towers behind, and a whole bunch of kills. 25 minutes in, this is not looking good in this best of 5. Losing 2 here would mean they'd have to win 3 in a row against H2K. And this is an H2K who have been looking sharp. They have made very few errors in their play. And this is a completely new H2K from what we've seen in other offline tournaments.
They've completely dictated the pace over every opponent they've had here in the expansion tournament, be it Meloncats in the game they played online, and Faculty just let H2K do whatever they wanted, and Giants are doing a very similar thing here. They're trying to make plays, but H2K are just beating them to the punch every single time, and Lulex has read Frederick very well in this game. You can see the difference between the two junglers right now, and every time Frederick wanted to do anything, Lulex has been there, and even Pepinero is having to run a little bit scared here in that middle lane because Odo Amne is huge in this game as well.
H2K now stranglehold over the top jungle here, trying to get the control over the Baron, and Giants need to try and contest this. Super Minions battering down on their front door as well. Augmented by that Baron buff is not what they need. Whirly B caught out here, maybe by Odo Amne, does get slowed down. Takes the lantern, the dark passes to Rydal, once again the savior of his team. Red buff will be going down here to Kianen. In fact, no, it went to Lulex. He came in with the last auto attack. But Biven moving back here. Giants are still pushing it out of their base, trying to take down this ward, sweeping it up. Lulex now coming in from the left-hand side. This could be a little bit bad for Giants as they come in here. Odo Amne comes out looking for the monsoon. We'll be scattering them aside. Lulex is in the back line. They take down the jungler. He was collapsing. But the ultimate, the shockwave doesn't hit anybody. Whirly B, the after auto attack follows him all the way through the lantern. Rydal now backs off. Pepinero has caught out Kianen, but he doesn't have the damage. He's just too far behind. The Q doesn't connect from Lulex. And now Forbidden is still chasing up, but Adri is being caught out by Odo Amne. He is right in his grill. He takes him down. 3-0, Pepinero still being chased after. He tries to get a kill forward on the return. Gets it with the Orb of Deception, but the rocket's coming from around the side. Odo Amne has now cued the Jaws music, but he's coming in for the kill. Moves on to Rydal, gets that one with an Equilibrium Strike. Pepinero soon to follow as well. He's getting chunked down by the laser. Ooh. He survives. A 1v3 though. Everyone's low, and Frederick is back from base. This has been such a long team fight. Lulex goes down, and Odo Amne has to go back to base. So does Forbidden.
H2K can't push from this, but all the way back at the beginning of this that fight, a kick out of Lulex and the Monsoon out of Voidal just kind of bunched Giants into one place. And from there, H2K just landed a lot of damage. Pep and Arrow at the end of that fight, though, getting so much work done, picked up a couple of kills that really could potentially have spelled the end of the game for Giants had H2K been able to push from that. But we do have a replay. Watch the kick and the Monsoon pretty much at the same time bunches everybody into that small little gap. They tried to get the Cataclysm out there, didn't deal enough damage, and Shockwave did kind of whiff there from Frederick, is from Forbidden actually. As yeah. Here's Pep and Arrow from the side. Lands a lot of damage, the hook follows up, and that's what Rydal's been doing so well this entire game. And meanwhile, there has been a little bit of action, a couple of kills on live, but Pep and Arrow again just getting another kill. It's a very extended team fight here out of Giants. Manages to land the charm, and we are back to the live game. Forbidden did fall, and Pep and Arrow.
Voidal gets exploded by Pep and Arrow, but now it won't be from the top lane. Heads in with the Transcendent Blades. He drops low. The box will be keeping the range. Jump over the wall here from Lee Sin, but he's right into the grabs of the Jarvan, and kicks him away outside of his Cataclysm. Flash forward to Mandry, picks him down, takes him down. Rydal from the bot side looking to land another hook. Isn't quite in range for this, but a 2-0, and Giants are back in strength.
They are, and they have a Jax. At this point, they can draw this game out later, and the more H2K kind of flounder around, taking fights that are very back and forth, it's not closing the game out for H2K. And now Giants potentially have the room to get back into this game. Inhibitor respawned during the replay, and now Giants are going to have to slow the pace a little bit. They have to bring H2K back into this game the way Giants want to. And that is to just not really let H2K get any picks and put Whirlybee over in a side lane.
So now Odawan, they 8-1. And speaking of that Irelia player, he's moving on to Pepinero. 4-3-6 right now, has 3 items. So he's in a fairly good place, plus the Sorcerer's Boots as well. Mid lane, again, look at Forbidden. He is 5-2-8. Again, 3 items on him, but he is slightly ahead. More expensive items on his side of the, his side of the board. Odawam, they found Rydal, though, just trying to ward up. What are you doing there? Lulex will take him down. A swift punch to the face will knock him into the death chamber.
And that is the kind of pick that they really cannot allow H2K to have. And Giants will now lose a third dragon to H2K, as they will get that added movement speed. And you can see it in effect here as Adri is trying to get away.
Oh, that's a lot of damage onto Lulex though, but Adri is getting chunked by Odawam. The heal flash forwards, get the Equilibrium Strike, the Indie carry down, he can't afford that to happen. Oh, Shockwave lands onto a Whirlybee as well. Tries to get the Spirit Rush in from Pepinero. Whirlybee has been knocked back into the fight, into the jaws of Hyannon. Meanwhile, the mid laner goes down. 2 big carries are down for the count. And Frederick is off to the side, but H2K not choosing to finish here. They don't have the minion, and they do not feel like they can go for this.
It looks like they want to back out and maybe look to set up for a Baron here, as they know they've got about 30 seconds before Pepinero is back onto Summoner's Rift, and this will make it very difficult for Giants to clear out, because right now Giants generally have good wave clear. Between Sivir, between Ahri, they can actually just wave clear through one lane, but Baroned up minions are a different issue. You put Irelia over with the Baroned up lanes in one lane, the rest of H2K in another, as Lulex is dropping very low. Frederick could be looking to come over the back of the wall here. You have to think it has to be a last-ditch attempt out of Frederick to try and get it. Kjarnan's going to try and play defense.
Well, he's going to jump over the wall to meet him. Gets the dog, passes back to his team. That may buy enough time. Frederick trying to come in here, jumps over the wall. It's going to be smited away by Lulek. The jungler goes down from bad to worse, and that may be the last nail in the coffin for Giants.
Whirlybee is pushing bot, but you can see Kjarnan very much in favor of the best defense is a good offense. Hopping over the wall, just completely taking Frederick's health down, and it's a tower that Giants are going to get. The problem with that is he's now got to run away from Lulex, and Odoamne is his first issue, and then they've got to try and besieged by Baroned up minions with this kind of advantage as well. I don't know whether their wave clear is good enough to withhold.
Oh, they'll try and hold on, but it's going to be tough in the next couple minutes. The storm is rapidly approaching, and Giants have to hunker down. H2K just going back to base, picking up a whole bunch of items as well. Aegis of the Legion, Voidstaff as well. Zephyr now onto Odawam. They, of course, that EU build onto Irelia. Has the Zephyr and the Triforce. Pepinero trying his best to just find a pick in the middle lane. A pick at this stage would buy them another good 40 to 50 seconds.
Willie B has managed to get himself back into this game with regards to CS. He's now at 242 to Irelia's 207. And while that would look good normally, with regards to the disparity between the two, 9 kills on Irelia makes it a very different prospect, especially with those 7 assists as well. Means that Odo Amne is very strong right now, and Willie B is still working on a Blade of the Ruined King for that extra attack speed. There we go. And, of course, lifesteal he's going to get from it as well. So now he's got a lot of dueling potential. They've got to be careful that Willie B doesn't manage to somehow find somebody in a fight or look to jump into the back line. But again, Mikhail's is on Janna. They're going to try and get Corki out of any kind of difficult situations. The inhibitor turret has gone down. This siege is just too strong out of H2K. There is nothing that Giants can do, even with the hard engage in this game.
Well, Giants have to find a time where they go for the engage. They have to at some point go for a fight, but they're just choosing to let the inhibitor go down. We'll see now if H2K move into the top lane or just do the same thing.
Yeah, their top lane, although they have kind of set it up a little bit to push in, they didn't really push it all the way in first, so it's just arriving in time for them as they can get up to that top lane, perhaps a little bit later than they would have liked it. But the fact of the matter is, 2 inhibitors are down. It's a tough spot for Giants. They've got to deal with 2 waves of super minions while Baroned up minions up in the top lane are pushing in as well. And Odo Amne is going to sit in the middle lane and make those mid lane minions even more difficult to deal with.
Well, EB is the only one who can really deal with them at this stage. Adri has to be in the top lane to go for the main wave clear against this big push, but those Baroned up minions are difficult to deal with. Odo Amne, Whirly B moving into the top side. Rydal looking for that hook, but only finds a minion.
He flashed for it,
too. He did flash for it as well. There's a shockwave. Support goes down. This will open up the team fight, whether Giants like it or not.
Whirly
B comes in. There is the flag and drag. Comes in with a cataclysm. He gets one, but there's the double kill. This is looks like it's the end. It will be Giants 3-1 so far. Hyonin picks up the kill. Adri comes in, but that's the Q connecting from Lulux. He'll chase after Tempest, the cripple. And now it's Peperino from the base. He's the only member surviving. Hyonin now coming in here, looking for the rockets. Lulex drops low, he'll most likely die. Peperino still has to go back to his base. Peperino now is the only member who can stop them from getting to that Nexus. Now the Nexus turrets are going down. Only one more remaining before they close out this game, but those are too many super minions flooding the base. Rydal is back, but it's not going to make the blindest bit of difference. The Nexus goes down. H2K take the second game in his best of 5 in the upper bracket finals. They are 1 game away from the LCS. Yes.
And Giants again in this situation, just were under a massive siege from H2K. This time, H2K just had so many lanes pushing into them and so much damage that H2K have just looked so good in Games 1 and Games 2. They have looked pretty much unstoppable so far.
Yeah, and absolutely just on the floor. They are shutting the door on the chances now for Giants to get into the LCS.
And it didn't matter whether you got the Jarvan away from Lulex, because he just picked Lee Sin. And from there, where do you go for the picks and ban strategy? You've chosen red side 5 games in a row. 2 games in and it hasn't worked out for you. You've not been able to control the flow of picks and bans at all yet. And Giants, they need to come up with something. They need something from their playbook that's completely different, potentially, to overcome H2K, because their standard way of playing just isn't working.
Yeah, and in any other series, it would be like, okay, now we're on blue side, now we can get the first pick, we can change up our tactics. But in this, they're red side every single game, no matter what happens, so they have to do something from the same position, and we might literally see a rinse and repeat from games 1 and 2. Well, we'll see if the analysts agree with us, we're going to head over there with Shox and the rest of the crew.
Thank you very much, guys. You did highlight it. They are red side on every game for this one, and they made some adaptations. Giants came out with a pretty good comp, but at the end didn't seem to play out that well.
Yeah, if you look at picks and bans every game so far, H2K has just banned out Syndax, Xerath, Elo Blanc, targeting Peperino there. Then this game, Giants kind of were doing Jace, Zed, and Rumble. They basically banned the Jace from game 1, and that left open Lee Sin. And then you saw that H2K is adaptive in their champ select, so they went for the Corki early. They really liked that pick. They liked the mid-game power spike and poke that it brings. But because Lee Sin was open, they basically gave away Jarvan and kind of Lee Sin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and on top of that, they have red side every single game, but they're not really taking advantage of it. They knew the Irelia was picked, and they picked Jax into it, which is kind of a skill matchup, but it's in favor of the Irelia. And the Lee Sin's just sitting there camping. He's like waiting right behind him the whole time. So if you have any kind of jungle pressure in that matchup, you saw they got like a double kill and just the lane just got completely out of hand.
Yeah, let's actually take a closer look at Lulux and his play, because he did play phenomenally in this game starting off. You want to talk a little bit about his jungling very early on, because he was so greedy.
Yeah, I'm actually really surprised that Giants coaching staff isn't pointing this out. Basically, he does the same jungle route every single game he plays, where he does this really greedy jungle route where he
gets a leash on Grump first.
Yeah. He gets a leash and he full clears the jungle. Okay.
There's a replay.
Yeah, never basically, mind. After that greedy clear, he basically camps top all the time. And why I wanted this replay here is just to point out the synergy between Odwamne and Lulix. They basically wait long enough, they say go, Odwamne opens with the stun, and by the time the stun ends, Lulix already in place to kick him out of space. Counter gank, there's just no time. He's just dead too quick. And from that moment on, top lane started snowballing. But I definitely agree with Sane here. He basically jungled for over a minute with 15% life, maybe.
Yeah, less than that sometimes.
If at any point Frederick walked to the edge of jungle that was completely not warded, he would have gotten killed. Completely tilted that matchup. Because every game so far has been Leash on Grump, Blue, Wolves, Raptors, Smite on Red to get more HP, and then barely dance like a dance of death with the Golems or the Krugs as they're called right now, and it's exploitable.
Yeah, and because he has that level advantage, because he does the greedy clear, he's always a level up on him. So if they do go into that head-to-head 2v2 top, and you're up a level with the jungler, then you're just going to win it every time.
Yeah, and in this one, Febiven was on Orianna, which is, of course, a very safe champ. And when the top lane is doing so well, you know how it's going to go from there. What should the Giants put their focus on? Still, the bottom lane, the 2v2 matchup, it isn't all that bad. Maybe Frederick should put some more work into there. They were pretty much pushed up, I think. No, they were pushed in. So.
Yeah, but Adrian and Rydell were playing well. Very even first, like, I think like 60 CS, but then even then after that, they started pulling ahead once more time. So it just shows that even though H2K first picked Corki, they still started losing lane again against that Sivir Thresh combo. So maybe that's something where Giants has to look like, okay, we'll give him Corki again, we'll take this, and we'll try and spice it up. I probably think they're going to drop the Rumble ban in the top lane and try and fit in like one more troublesome pick here to get away with it. But I think they're running out of options basically because they're stuck on the purple side, and they're trying to use their last pick to their advantage, but it doesn't matter if you lose the draft already in the first like round and you get outpicked by just getting first pick to Jarvan or bait into Jarvan and get counterpicked with Lee.
Yeah, it seems like they created more problems for themselves because now the Aurelia gets picked, they can't pick the Gnar anymore, they know the Mundo is a threat, even that top lane, Odwamne is really showing up.
Well, I'm actually surprised they didn't pick Mundo into the Aurelia take one out of the world. Like, oh, well, the Mundo looked pretty good when we played against it. I mean, maybe he doesn't play the Mundo, he's not experienced in it, but I mean, who doesn't play Mundo? It's pretty easy.
Cleavers.
Pretty easy matchup. Like, I'm sure you could like pull Mundo.
I'm not sure, but yeah. Just Cleaver and all day long. Yeah. Guys, it does look like your prediction might come true. Think it's going to be a clean 3-0 here for H2K?
I don't even know what I would do if I was in Giant shoes other than trying to shut Lulex down early.
Unless they start the jungler down, I don't see any way they're going to be able to do this. So they just really need to focus on shutting down the jungler.
Yeah, maybe they have a magical plan up their sleeves with that red side again now in game 3. We will see. The Giants are 0-2 down and the H2K is one game away from qualifying to the European LCS. Can they do it? We'll see you next.